how do you build going forward at this point? I mean, I imagine you've been communicating with sponsors, fans, obviously, as you said, they're thrilled. But how do you rebuild a team that's been through all this?
I think that is, it's never easy, right, to sort of build esprit de corps and to put the kind of talent on the court that you need to be winners. But we got a really big jump on it. There's no question that this team came together behind Doc. Doc was a key player. Doc really stood up. Doc was a man. Doc was somebody who led when leadership was needed. We've got all the guys coming back who were, you know, the heart and soul of the Clippers. We had a good draft. We picked up a kid named Wilcox, who's going to be terrific, I'm sure. A couple of free agents who signed on. So I think the team is going to be actually stronger. I think it'll be more united behind Doc. I think the staff is thrilled to see an owner like Steve Ballmer, who's going to invest in this team, coming on board. I think the fans are going to be not only excited but surprised at the product that we put on the court. So this is one of those, you know, resilience is always a key to success. This is one of those where people are going to see the resilience of the Clippers. They're going to come off this floor, and they're going to make some noise this year.
Oh, it's a good story, I think, for people in the community to get enthused about. Let me ask you about Steve Ballmer.
Were you? Community, I mean, well, this became an American story.
Yeah.
It really did. I've said before, this team actually has the potential to become sort of America's team because of the way they went through this firestorm, the way they hung together, and the way they're going to come out of their corner when the season starts.